Hello everyone, this is Nirjhar Gupta from Department of Civil Engineering, SIRT Bhopal under the SAGE group. In today's lecture, we are going to learn about the different cross-sectional elements of the road, in which we'll be focusing today for the camber of the road and the curves of the road. In the previous lectures, we have studied about the different pavement characteristics, in which we have already discussed about the friction, that how friction is helpful in the road. Along with the friction, we have discussed more over the types of frictions, in which we have discussed about the longitudinal friction and lateral frictions. After that, we have differentiated the skid and slip also, that how they are responsible and how they are helpful in designing part. Also, we have discussed about the skid and slip in context with the translational and rotational motion. After that, we have discussed about the light reflection characteristics, that is, what benefits are for the blacktop or the bituminous type of pavement and what benefits are there for the cement concrete pavement. Along with that, with the last topic that we have already discussed in the previous lecture, that is unevenness index, in which we have calculated the undulations on the road surface by using the bump integrator, which was developed by Central Road Research Institute. Now for today's lecture, we'll be focusing more over the camber, cross slope, transverse slope, and in railways we call it same as the cant. So this is, in if we move ahead about the camber, then we have seen that camber is provided by raising the middle portion of the road surface. For example, suppose if we are having this blue type of road, this is the straight road, and on this straight road, we have to provide the camber. If the road is flat and straight, the main purpose of camber could not be fulfilled, which is to drain off the surface water from the pavement. So in order to drain the surface water from the pavement, we have to raise the middle portion of the pavement such that if any water comes on the surface of the pavement, it can be easily drained off. So this is the main purpose of the camber, and along with that, we have three different types of camber that are on the surface, how we are providing the camber and which type of camber is more suited for the type of road. Like we are having the cement concrete pavement also, we are having the bituminous pavement also, and we are having WBM roads also. So majorly, if we see, then we have to provide the cambers. And straight line camber, if we see, then straight line camber is provided on the cement concrete roads. So I am moving forward with the types of the pavement, the types of camber that are provided over the pavement. The first we have, that is the straight line camber. In this straight line camber, as the name indicates, we are providing the camber in the form of straight line only, such that suppose if we are having this any road, earlier it was the flat surface and we were asked to provide the camber on the road, and also we are asked to provide the straight line camber. Under that conditions, we'll look for the center portion of the road, and after that center portion of the road, we'll just along it towards the crown portion, or we'll just extend it or raise the center portion so that we can have the straight surface. If we see, then this is the straight surface, and overall this will be the overall width of the pavement, which we denote by the W, capital W. And also we must have the slope for what we have provided, so we can name it as 1 in n, or we can look for the theta also, that by what degree you have raised the surface or why, what percentage you have provided the slope. These all depends upon the type of road and also depends on the type or on the intensity of the rainfall, that on what area is experiencing the rainfall. Like we are having the heavy rainfall or the in the area there is light rainfall. Depending upon that situation, rainfall data also, the camber is being decided. So this is the straight line camber. Now moving towards the second type, that is the parabolic camber. As the name suggests, the parabolic, we are very familiar that parabola is having a trajectory. So here also we are having the same trajectory, and we can see that here, suppose if we have any road like this, the flat surface of the road, and we have been asked to provide the parabolic cambers, in that conditions we will first look the center of the road. Suppose this is the center point of the road, and the same we are having the W width of the road. So under this condition, if we see, then we have to join the para, we have to provide the curve surface, and this curve surface will be raised by the Y axis. So if we can see clearly that in the same process, like we have raised the surface in the previous, in the straight line camber, in the same process we have raised here also in the parabolic camber. And if you are being asked to find the coordinates, then in order to find the coordinates, we are having the x-axis and y-axis. Suppose this is your x-axis, in which we are having here the positive, in which we are having here the negative. This is the center portion, and we are having the slope, the same will be asked, that is 1 in n, the slope we are having, and the width of the pavement is already mentioned, that is the W. So if we have to find out, then we can find the Y coordinates by simply the formula we have, that is the 2x square upon n W, where Y is the any coordinate on the Y axis, and N is the slope provided, and W is the width of the pavement. So we can easily find out the straight line camber also, and we can easily find out the parabolic cambers also, the coordinates of both type of camber. Now if we see, this is the second part, I have forgot to mention that this is the second part, that is the B part, we call it as the parabolic. This is the surface is parabolic in nature, that is the curved surface. So that's why we have provided the parabolic, and we have named it also the parabolic camber. Now the last type of camber is the combination of straight line and the parabolic camber. As the name suggests, you can just find and make it clear in your mind that in this type of camber, we are providing the straight line also and the parabola also. Now let's see about, I am just erasing all this straight line and parabolic camber. In this, the most important thing is that you have to remember this formula, as it is being in the parabolic camber formula that has been asked in the competitive exams. So it is being I request you to please recall it and note it down, so that you can just recall and make use of this formula. So moving ahead to the combination of straight line and parabolic camber, we have, as the name suggests, first the straight line. So suppose again we are having this straight road surface, which is having the width of W. We are considering the width of the pavement as W. So after that, we have to provide the straight line and the parabolic camber. So it is very easy. First, we will provide the straight line cambers, that is on the edges we provide the straight line cambers, and on the top surface we will provide the parabolic camber such that this is the proper structure. If I am just highlighting the top surface of the road, this is the combination of two, that is this blue part, this corner part is the straight line camber, as you can clearly see on your screens, and this part is the parabolic camber. Now this type of camber is very much useful in the areas of heavy rainfall, as the straight line cambers is preferred over the cement concrete pavement because the camber is very less in that, and also the parabolic cambers is very much helpful for the fast moving vehicle, as its central portion, if you could clearly see, this center portion is flat in surface, so this flat surface provides the fast movement for the vehicles to move. So in the areas of heavy rainfall where the fast moving traffic is also there, we can provide the combination of straight line as well as parabolic camber. So but if from the point of constructions, if we see, then the straight line camber is very much easy to provide in the cement concrete pavement, whereas the parabolic camber is easy to provide in the bituminous type pavement, or we generally call it as black top roads, okay, or flexible pavement. So this was all about the different types of camber. Now moving ahead, we are, as per the IRC, we are having certain values for the camber and along with the type of pavement, as already discussed in the previous slide, that the camber is useful in the draining of the rainwater. So it depends upon the rainfall also, that if we are having heavy rainfall, we have to provide the large slope, large percentage, and if there is light rainfall, we can provide the small camber also. So if we see the different types of pavement, and for your information, the all the values are the standard values, and they are as per the IRC. IRC is what? Indian Road Congress, and it is such codes that provides the guidelines for the road constructions only, okay. So in the cement, we see the type of pavement, we are having the cement concrete or high bituminous type pavement in the areas where there is heavy rainfall. In such areas we have to provide the 2%, and if the same type of pavement is provided in the areas of light rainfall, then we can provide the less percentage or less slope of the camber, that is 1.7 and 2%. Same is the case with the thin bituminous type pavement. Bituminous means flexible road or bitumen road or blacktop road, where we are providing the thin bituminous type pavement, and in that the areas of heavy rainfall we have to provide the 2.5%, and in the areas of light rainfall we have to provide the 2%. Similarly, for the WBM or the gravel road, we are increasing the percentage, that is 3% in the areas of heavy rainfall and 2.5% in the areas of light rainfall. And for the earth road or the kacha road, we are providing the 4% camber, and in the areas of heavy rainfall, similarly in the areas of light rainfall, we will be providing the 3%. So if we see, we are increasing the percentage of the camber as we are degrading the type of pavement. That is just because in the WBM roads or in the earth road, the water percolation is high as compared to the bituminous or concrete pavement. So if in order to reduce the water percolation, that the ground or the road should not absorb the water, if we are providing the high slope, then the water just runs off very easily. So based on that concept only, the camber is being raised as we are degrading the type of pavement. So this was all about the camber and its values based on the Indian Road Congress. And why we have to prefer the Indian Road Congress? Because we should have the standardized value for the camber. So this was all about the cambers and the types of camber. Now we are coming over the next topic, that is the curbs. Now curbs are, if we see the curbs, they are the component of the city roads only. Okay, now the city roads, why we are providing the curbs? Because it is a vertical or the sloping member that is provided along the edge or the shoulder to give strength and to protect the edge of the pavement. In other words, if we see, then the curbs are the barrier or boundaries for the road. But in the highway engineering, it indicates the boundary between the pavement and the shoulder. And sometimes it also is act as a boundary between the island or rotary or footpath or car parking space. Depending upon the type of curb and depending upon the use of curb, the curbs are divided on the different types. Like we are having the four different types of the curb. The first is low or mountable type curb. Second is semi-barrier type curb. Third one is barrier type curve, and fourth is submerged curve. Now moving ahead about the low or mountable type curve, so that first I would like to show you that here in this image, this white strip is the road boundary. Okay, this is what the road boundary. So in order to protect or just to create the boundary for the road and for the shoulders or the pavement, we have constructed this wall. So this wall or this structure is termed as curbs. So now moving ahead on the types of curb, I hope the concept of curb is very much clear to you all. Now depending upon this curb, we have four different types, and we are in on which we are moving ahead. Like for the low or mountable, the first type is low or mountable type curb. Now if we see this type of roadside curb is provided such that they encourage the traffic to remain in the traffic lanes, and also the driver to enter the shoulder area with very much little difficulty. Worth noting point is that the height of this curb is about 10 centimeter above the pavement edge, and with a slope which allows the vehicle to climb easily. This is usually provided at medians, that is the dividers, and channelized schemes, and also help in the longitudinal drainage. From the figure, that is the, you can easily make out this is carriageway is nothing but the road. So for this road or the carriageway, this side portion that we have, curved portion that we have provided, this is what curbs. And with this curbs, if we see the height of this low or mountable type curve is 10 centimeters only. And if we have any much requirement or we are in emergency, then in certain cases we can easily climb through this curve and change our lane. So that is the function of the low or mountable type curve. Now moving ahead to the second type of curve, that is the semi-barrier type curve. In this semi-barrier type curve, when the pedestrian traffic is very high, pedestrians means the person, those who are walking on their foot, they are termed as the pedestrian traffic is high, then these curbs are provided, and their height is above 15 centimeter above the pavement edge. That is, it is more having the more height than the lower mountable type curve, and this type of curve prevents the encroachment of the parking vehicle. But when at the acute emergency, when in the cases of very emergency cases, it is possible to drive over this curve with certain difficulty. So the point that is very much worth noting, the height, that is the 15 centimeter. Their height is about the 15 centimeter, and here also the road or the carriageway. This is the road or carriageway, and this portion is what? The curbs. And which type of curb it is? Semi barrier type curb, such that in the cases of acute emergency we can climb on this curb, or we can use this on this curb for the purpose or the use of the vehicles only in the cases of emergency. And we have to provide such type of curbs in the for the pedestrian traffic, where the pedestrian traffic is high. So now moving ahead on the different third type, that is the barrier type curb. In this, these are designed to discourage vehicles from leaving the pavement. That is, they are designed such that so that the vehicles remain in their lane only, in the on the pavement only, and they are provided when there is considerable amount of pedestrian traffic. Where their pedestrian traffic is very high, then they are provided such that on the top surface we can easily use it for the purpose of pedestrians. Like this top surface can be used for the pedestrian traffic, and similarly if we see the height of the curb, that is 20 centimeter, and they have just created the barrier to the surface. So this was all about the barrier type curb. And the last type we are having, that is the submerged curb. Now these type of curb are used on the rural roads, on the WBM or earth road or the kacha road that are provided in the Pradhan Mantri Gramin Sadak Yojana's road. And these curbs are provided at pavement edges, between the pavement and the shoulders, and so that they can provide the lateral confinement and also the stability to the pavement. And we can see that in this submerged curb, either we can provide this type of curb with the concrete or these large stones by placing them along the side of the road, beneath the road surface. As the name indicates, the submerged, there is no curb on the top portion. That means this carriageway or the road is connected directly with the shoulders, and you can just move or walk over this submerged curb. The main purpose is to provide the lateral stability and the increase the life of the roads. So this was all about the different types of curb. If we see, we have all discussed about the types of curb, we have discussed about the camber of the road, and if we see about the different things, that is the different cross-sectional elements, we have discussed about pavement characteristics, we have discussed about camber, we have discussed about the curb. Now in the next session or in the next lecture, we'll be discussing about the width of the pavement, we'll be discussing about the divider and median, we'll be discussing shoulders and width of formation. So I thank you all for patiently listening the lecture, and hope you all have understood about the pavement characteristics, you have understood about the camber and the curb. Thank you, everyone.